times before top eight.
Yeah.
How you doing, Quid?
Yeah, we I feel like we've like formed a connection with Quid here tonight. We spent quite a lot of time.
I've rooted for Quid. I've rooted very hard against Quid. Now we're here at the culmination of hopefully not the culmination, if Quid has anything to say about it.
It's the culmination of one of these players.
That is correct.
And now we see which it is. We're not going to be seeing the Sephiroth, actually, from Ned. We're going to see the Pyromancer, which he's been playing a little bit tonight.
Makes a lot more sense. Because honestly, think about, like, Squirtle and Ivysaur. Pyro and Mithra. Think about it. Charizard's not really there.
I would say it's more like Squirtle and Charizard.
Yeah, but he's not playing Charizard.
Yeah.
Imagine Charizard. Imagine Ivysaur had fire hitboxes, and now we're close.
Right. And a flame, anyway. Flame wheel.
I'd rather not.
Either way, gonna get hit with that. I think it's Foresight. It's called from Pyromancer. You can kind of just decide you're not gonna combo them anymore. And it happens. But yep. One thing I like here is that Ned wasn't doing in this previous set, that we watched at least, is that he's going for a lot more ledge traps. He stopped going for exclusively edge guards, and he's going to sit at roll distance and kind of just wait for your options to try to react, which yep. I think is a smart option when you're playing these sword type characters.
Oh my god. Okay, so what I'm seeing is that Quid has spent the last 45 seconds just getting hit.
Yeah. He spent the majority of the game just kind of getting juggled by Mithra. We haven't seen Pyro once yet. Oh!
That entire stock. I know Ned took 88%. That's a lie. Ned controlled that entire game for 2 straight minutes.
That is an illusion.
Yeah.
Your eyes
It's an elaborate ruse created to trick you.
Yeah. The birds are fake. But that F smash is not. The F smash is very
Wow. Good. That F smash did so much. I didn't even see Ned get hit before that.
That's crazy.
Ivysaur is so strong.
Man, that's insane. But Ned is still putting on the pressure. He's not using like any Pyra. I think part of it is because he does not want to do Squirtle against Pyra. Very, very fast, yeah. Very small yeah. against slow fire girl, essentially.
Mm-hmm. And we're seeing a continuation of one of the first things that I talked about with Quid on stream a scant 3 hours ago, which is that Quid is making all of the hits count. Like, he's getting extensions off of, like, every single straight hit that he can. And right now, that is critically important because Ned is, like we talk about time of possession, Ned is dominating time of possession right now.
He is, but if you're looking at these percents, it's like you said, it's about even. Yep. I think this is
a Chip Kelly at Oregon game right now.
Able to find back air. Yeah, just kind of juggling. And we finally see Pyra's shown up. She is.
Wait, Pyra and Charizard? Oh my god, you were right.
It's the same back air. It looks like that almost took Charizard off the top, which is insane. And Pyra's gone. Pyra did great. Oh, there she is again.
Everyone did great. Wait, no, this makes perfect sense. This makes perfect sense. Because Quid plays Pokemon Trainer and has 2 characters that he uses and 1 that he doesn't really. And then Pyra and Mithra have that dork in the diving suit that they brought with them that doesn't do anything.
True. It's the same
thing. So it all works out.
So you're saying Rex is Charizard?
Yes. Yeah, I think that I am.
Just making sure that I'm understanding clearly.
I'm going to say that I am saying.
Okay.
Yes.
Doubling down on that one.
I'm going to commit to the saying yes.
Great.
Hey, what the hell? Ned's losing.
Yeah, we started
kind of
being idiots, and now he's losing.
I grabbed onto the orb of confusion.
Oh no. Okay, he's able to still bring himself back into it. He's
going for the apartment.
You cannot do that against Quid. You can't make a mistake.
Where are you going?
He was going for an uppie. He was trying to do. He was like, oh, okay, Sakurai showed me this. I can do the uppie off stage two. No, you can't. Now Quid's doing that. Active hitbox from the Nair. Links right into that uppie. He has gotten so many stocks tonight from that. from what we've seen.
Oh my god. As soon as I saw that Uppy going the wrong way, I was like, oh my god, Enzo Edgeguard's coming. It's coming right now. Like, oh my god.
Oh no, you're just dead. It's just, yeah, it's just how it works.
That's insane. Time of possession lies, ladies and germs. Literally every time, I think every time I've brought up time of possession on commentary tonight, it's been like somebody who lost time of possession. It's been about somebody who lost time of possession and won the game.
Yeah. Yeah, consistently it has been. Because yeah. I think that's the point. The point is that.
Right. Like, you won't, that's when you really notice it.
Mm-hmm.
Because it should work the other way around.
Like, take Jade Tails versus Quinn. Time of possession was obviously in Quinn's favor, and he also just kind of destroyed. Double three stock. You don't need to comment on it then, because it's obvious. Yeah. When it goes the other way, it's like, oh. But I think
that's an understandable air dodge, because it looked like Quid was should have been able to make that back.
Yeah, it's just unfortunate is the best way to put it.
But Quid's been doing a really, really good job of digging his way out of holes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, maybe he's just trying to set the bar a little bit higher.
Yeah, he's started to dig, but I also think back to time possession. I think we talk about it most when we're talking about characters that are very fast but don't put on a lot of damage. Like, Squirtle puts on damage, but you know, very fast in your face. That's the idea of it.
Or Pyra, or Mithra, perhaps.
Or Mithra, exactly.
Yeah.
But it's even on this, even on the percent, but still a stock disadvantage. We'll see what Ned can go for here. Maybe a Pyra switch to try to...
Oh, boy.
Try to get some extra... get the stock, really.
Yeah. Oh, man. The Magnet Hands came in just right on time for Ned there.
Yeah. I mean, Air Dodge just at kind of the perfect distance time. Just able to make it back without really any sweat. We see Pyra put up that flaming wall. Let's see what they can do here on ledge, though.
I don't think that Ned is at up smash kill percent right now from Charizard.
I don't believe so.
I don't think that's going to kill. I could be wrong. I mean, Charizard is at max rage. And Charizard does have other moves that will kill here.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think it's quite, but it's going to put him in a bad position. Now I think you're starting to, probably going to swap to, yeah, swap to Mr.
Oh, wow, what coverage there from Quid. Keeping the stocks even. Definitely giving himself a chance on final stock, and it's gone. But now, Quid probably feels safe to go back to the Squirtle, which we've said all night has really been Quid's most effective character to our eyes.
Yeah, from what we've seen, his Squirtle has been his go-to.
But Ned is saying go to that platform and stay there.
Yeah. I think it's hard for Squirtle to really... Oh, okay. Yeah, that's fine. I think it's hard for Squirtle to shine against a character like Mithra, which excels in a lot of the same ways where you get those combos. It's hard to really... Plus, you have the disjoint. It's like, what do you really do? Yeah, that was... Yeah, all right, that was an example of time of possession.
No, I'm gonna hit you with another football metaphor.
Okay.
Because when I think about the beginning of this game,
mm-hmm.
Ned won the turnover battle. Because that's what happened. And time of possession may not be a stat that correlates very well with win percentage, but turnover battle absolutely is. If you have those turnovers at the beginning of the game, mm-hmm. you're practice that was a pick six. On the opening drive.
Yeah.
So it makes you wonder, like, had that turnover gone differently, what kind of game are we looking at? And I hope that we get to see that answer in game three, because I really want to see I want to see these games properly come down to the wire. Cause both players at this point, like both players having made it this far in losers, they deserve that.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, We'll see if any other metaphors disclose themselves in this game three scenario.
Maybe we'll switch to basketball.
Maybe we'll switch to baseball. You never know.
Okay. Yeah. Alright. Who's got the Aoife's pitch here?
All I know is we are watching Super Smash Brothers.
Yeah.
That is what I know.
Sometimes.
Occasionally. We're going to be going to Battlefield. Already a better start coming out from Quid. Able to find that, do Squirtle things, essentially.
I mean, he's done, like, literally 60 times more damage. 70 times more damage. Oh, my.
Okay. Promising if your Quid stands go nuts.
Ned taketh and Ned giveth away.
It's the SD. It happens. Yeah. It happens to both. It switches to Pyra, and this is just I'm behind. Let me hit hard with Sword Girl, and it works. It's working.
Yeah. That momentary like release of the pressure valve, because right now the situation looks a lot better. You still haven't taken the stock yet, but the percents, it looks like how it should look if you lost your stock first normal under normal circumstances.
Yeah, I love that down smash where you kind of just dash forward with it as well. I think one of the things is a matter of tempo. And if you're constantly playing with Mythra, you're playing the game at a certain speed. If you switch to Pyro when your opponent is not expecting it, they might not be mentally prepared to deal with it because you're expecting, okay, fast, weak. Instead, if you switch it up when they're not expecting it, it's, okay, now I need to learn to deal with this. Messing with the tempo can be really good, especially when you have two characters to play around with. Just like that.
Mm-hmm. But it should also be noted that you're not just messing with your opponent's tempo, but you also have to be prepared for the switch in your own tempo.
Exactly.
Because the switch from Pyra to Mythra is very, very drastic. Wow.
Yeah. Just kind of.
Quid managed to actually extend the lead. And now like. Quid has the license to play so much Squirtle right now because this stock is so healthy. Unless that pizza cutter has something to say about it.
It does. Well does have something to say about it. But this is looking rough for Ned. I honestly don't know if the Mythra is going to be enough. I think he's going to need to use a lot of that Pyra because Mythra is good when you can kind of exert yourself in neutral over and over again, but Squirtle can do the same thing.
Yeah.
And hit for hit, I think Squirtle is going to be, has those highly damaging combos, whereas you need a little bit more with Mythra.
It looks like Quid's... Oh, no. I don't even get to say my point, because that is Quid jab-locking his way through to losers, and that is knocking Ned out of this tournament at 13th place.
Yeah, they're very...